first hole here?
The opening hole here at TPC Summerlin really sets the tone for your round. It's more a ball in line to attack this green. It's a green that sits just a little lower down than the fairway and is really receptive to your wedge shots. It's a good hole to get your round underway on.
Thanks, Luke. Talk to you soon. Going with the 9-iron. And I think he's going to like that. From 15 feet. And that one will go for birdie. And starting the round off with a birdie is not a bad plan. And now let's move to the second hole.
I'll be back in a sec. I have to go wash the baby.
Ooh, look at that drive go.
Sorry about that, I'm back.
About 100 yards to the pin from here. This one's looking a bit long, folks. All right, and he's on. And this putt's for birdie. And that one will drop. And sitting at 2 under 4 of the day. Now let's see what this third hole has in store. Pretty sure this is going to land in the fairway here. And from 160 yards out.
This course is short, man.
That's a pretty inspiring shot just there, hitting this par 5 green in 2 definite eagle possibilities.
Get an hole. Oh my word, dude.
Drops.
A putt.
And he's going to move up in the standings after that hole.
-4 after hole 3.
Teeing off on this par 4.
Couldn't be better.
And just absolutely pounded this drive.
Flat ball. 240. 46%. Not bad.
And about $125 away.
This course is so short. Here's my walker all the way.
Here's a 9-iron.
Sit down, boy.
Yeah, that this could good. Be long.
Nah, it's not long. Almost hit the pin.
Beautiful. That'll play safely on the dance floor there. And this for the birdie.
Oh.
And it's time to take a peek at the leaderboard.
What a pity. Anyways.
And no change for him leaderboard wise after that hole. Okay, let's see what the fifth has in store today.
Running towards the pin. Two down, 8-iron. Pitch right there. Get aloft. Get an hole.
This is going towards the green here.
Ooh. Sit down. Sit. Yes.
And this one's about 4 feet from the cup.
Nice and solid, but. Back in a sec.
And after that one, we will stay at the top of the leaderboard.
Alright, let's go.
And now
this course is a little bit easy, to be honest. Based on the length. I hit it on the footpath. Like a bounce, I'll hit straight to the bushes. Let her rip. Go ball. Bounce, please. Bounce. Bounce, bounce, bounce. Nice.
And pitching range. Like that.
Might go check on the baby soon as well. I have to check on the baby. Like this. Yep, baby crying. I'll be back in a sec after this shot. Give me a sec. It's alright.
And I am pretty sure he's gonna like that. And setting up 13 feet from the cup here.
Sorry about that, guys. Just had to check on the baby.
Oh, I thought that was gonna go.
Tough putt. Real tough putt.
And with a tap, they'll get a par.
Nice houses on the outside there, on the estate.
And after that one, 5 under.
3 houses.
And let's see what the seventh hole has in store.
So I can get an eagle somewhere. I'll definitely go for that little piece of fairway. Let's go for it. It's not the safest option yet.
Nicely done. Looking like we'll have some fairway here.
bounce around the middle. Look ahead, sit down. Beautiful. Flop shot. We'll just chuck a bit of spin on that. A little bit to the right side. Good enough.
And this putt is for birdie.
Nice. It's almost too hard there.
And after that one, he's still in first place. And now getting ready to tee off on this par 3.
Long par 3 for a short course. Though when they run on that right side. Meters down. Try a bit of loft on it.
Looks like the hybrid is on display
here. Yeah, it's taking way too much wind. It's off the green.
And I think he's gonna like that.
I don't fucking like that, it sucks. Okay, chip it in. A little bit of spin. Oh, that's so skew, mate. Look at that.
And this putt to save par. And a nice putt. And after that one, there's 6 under for the day. And on to the 9th hole. And fantastic distance on this drive. From 205 yards out. That looks like the hybrid. And this one's definitely heading towards the green. Okay, and hitting this par 5 in 2 is going to set up some definite eagle possibilities. This one's about a 7-footer. And that one will drop for birdie. And as he finishes up his front 9, Luke, he's found himself in a pretty good place to be.
Oh, I love this part of any tournament, John. 9 holes to go. They call it the finish, the championship finish. Who's got the strongest mind as well as the most complete game? Will this leader be able to take it all the way to the house? Gee, I hope so.
Thanks, Luke. We'll talk to you on the 18th. Well, this one's looking like it's finding the fairway. And he's got to be happy with that.
This one looks about 4 feet.
And that one goes in for the bird.
And he's sticking to the same position he was at after that hole.
Okay, now moving on to the 11th. This one's looking pretty good so far.
And about 125 yards to the pin.
Going with the 9-iron here. I think this might be a bit long. And I think that one will play on the green. And this one's for birdie. This for the par. And he's going to stay right there where he was on the leaderboard. No change in the ranking. Okay, moving on to the 12th. This is looking fairway bound. And this one's looking pretty good. And he's on the green.
And about 10 feet to go here.
Ooh, and it just misses.
And this one's about 3 feet from the cup.
And that putt's gonna drop for par. And after that one, sitting at 8 under par for the day. And that also means he is in first place on the leaderboard. And look at this drive, just screaming off the club face. And he's probably gonna like that. Going with the 8-iron. Well, this is definitely heading towards the green. And he'll be happy with that. And about 11 feet to go here. Now let's take a look at the leaderboard. And as we check the standings, he's still in first after that one. And the wind could come into play on this one. I know some others have had some issues. Let's see how this tee shot goes. Pretty sure he's gonna like that one. And this one's for birdie.
Almost.
And this putt is for par. And he will stay right where he is on the leaderboard after that hole. And moving on to the 15th here. This putt's for birdie. So close. And tapping in for the par. And after that hole, currently sitting at 8 under. And next up, we have a par 5 hole. It's looking like it's heading into the fairway. And about 175 yards away here. And here's the 6-iron. Fantastic work on this par 5, hitting the green in 2. And that will drop for eagle. Okay, and he's still in first place, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, and setting up on his 17th tee. Feet to the cup. And that one goes for birdie. And no change in his leaderboard status after that hole. Teeing it up here on the 18th. Okay, and 135 yards to the pin. And going with the 9-iron. Looks like this could have a bit too much club on it. And I think he will be pleased with that. And this next putt for final round 60 on the scorecard. And about 4 feet from the cup. And the par putt will drop. And he's done it, folks. You are now looking at the Shriners Hospital for Children Open champion.
This will be a great victory on their resume. To win anywhere is a big deal. But right here in Las Vegas at the Shriners Hospitals for Children Open,